बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, वेलकम टू डीएचए एजुकेशन सिस्टम। वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर नंबर 3, बिगनिंग ऑफ हिंदू एंड मुस्लिम नेशनलिज्म। वी हैव स्टार्टेड दिस चैप्टर लास्ट वीक एंड वी विल कंप्लीट इट टुडे। दिस चैप्टर कवर्स द टाइमलाइन फ्रॉम 1885 टू 1911। दीज आर द रिसोर्सेज, your book understanding history by Ismat Riaz. This is chapter number 3 of your this book, and you can also take help from the history and culture of Pakistan by Nigel Kelly. These are the objectives. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to recall the previous lesson, describe the formation of the Muslim League in 1906, evaluate the causes of the formation of the Muslim League, and interpret Minto Morley reforms. Let's recall what we have read the last week. We read about the Albert Bill, which was passed by C.P. Albert, the law member of the Viceroy's Council. This bill is known as Albert Bill, and it was introduced in 1883. Then we read about the partitioning of Bengal. Bengal was the largest of the provinces of the subcontinent. So British found it difficult to administer it as one unit. So they decided to partition Bengal. Then we also discussed the effects of this partition on both Hindus and the Muslims. The Muslims were very happy with the partition and they greatly welcomed it. But the Hindus opposed it and they started violent protest, and predominantly they started the Swadeshi movement, in which they boycotted the British made goods. And this attitude of the Hindus towards the partitioning of Bengal made the Muslim to come to the decision that they could not trust both the Hindus and the British government for the protection of their rights. Because the British reversed the partition of Bengal because they got pressurized because of the protest by the Hindus, and they partitioned it in 1911. The reaction of the Hindus towards the partitioning of Bengal disappointed the Muslims. So they came to the conclusion that they need to have their own political body. So they made Indian National All India Muslim League in 1906, because Indian National Congress had only become a Hindu predominant party and it was only safeguarding the rights of the Hindus. So the All India Muslim League was a political party which was established in 1906 in British India. Its strong advocacy for the establishment of a separate Muslim majority nation state Pakistan successfully led to the partition of India in 1947 by the British Empire. So the formation of All India Muslim League is very important in the history of the subcontinent, because All India Muslim League provided a platform for the Muslim where they got united and they strived for their common aim, which was to get independence, and finally the subcontinent was partitioned and Pakistan was created. Let's have a look at the objectives of All India Muslim League. During the time of Sir Sayyid, the need for a political party of the Muslim was not fully realized, because as long as he lived, he fully performed the functions of a political party. But after his death, there was an urgent need for the Muslim political party. In 1885, when Indian National Congress was formed, Sir Sayyid advised the Muslims not to join Indian National Congress, as this party was only working for the benefits of Hindus. Moreover, Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan was afraid that the whole blame of the agitation, or if anything negative is done in the subcontinent, the whole blame will be again put on the Muslims. So he wanted the Muslims to be away from the political activities of Indian National Congress. By the 1900, the political conditions in India has showed that the Hindu-Muslim relations were not cordial anymore. One example of it was their reaction towards the partitioning of the Bengal. Due to these unhealthy condition, the Muslims of subcontinent forced to form their own political party apart from Indian National Congress for the protection of their rights. We can categorize the causes which were behind the formation of All India Muslim League. There are basically five main causes which led towards the formation of All India Muslim League. Number one is the Hindi-Urdu controversy. We have read about the Hindi-Urdu controversy when we discussed about Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. In 1898, Indian National Congress demanded that India should be treated as a cultural whole and Hindi should be declared as the official language of India. So they completely ignored the aspirations of the Muslim and attacked their language, which was very dear to them. So it was an eye-opener for the Muslims at that time also. Then the behavior of different Hindu organizations, predominantly Arya Samaj, which demanded that the Muslims should be forcibly converted into Hinduism. So that was an attack on Muslims' religion. Then Hindu-Muslim riots, the frequent and never-ending riots between Hindus and Muslims further strengthened the formation of separate political party for the Muslims. Reaction of the Hindus to the partition of Bengal, the negative reaction of the Hindus when the government declared the partition of Bengal in 1905 further convinced the Muslims to establish their own separate political organization. Because this partition, it reinforced the division between the Muslims and the Hindus. And Muslims finally came to the conclusion that if they want to safeguard and protect their rights, they needed to have their own political body. Shimla Deputation, very important, which was a deputation led by Sir Aga Khan. They met Lord Minto in 1906. Lord Minto became a Viceroy of India in 1906. At that time, it was felt that some constitution reforms would be introduced in India. Lord Minto was vacationing at Shimla, where a delegation of Muslim leaders led by Sir Aga Khan met him in 1906. The deputation demanded the seats in the legislature's quota, in government services, and seats in courts for the Muslims. They also demanded for separate electorate for the Muslims, the very important one. Minto accepted most of the demands and it was a great success for the Muslims. After the acceptance of demands from Lord Minto, now Muslims of India realized that it's the high time to organize a political party which can protect the rights of the Muslims in India. So actually the Muslims are encouraged by their success in persuading Lord Minto to allow separate electorates, and they decided that this was the right time to form their own political body. Political role of All India Muslim League for the Muslims of the subcontinent. Definitely it played very important role, like I told you that it played the role of a platform where the Muslim got united under the leadership of Qadi Azam later on. The All India Muslim League was a political party in British India. With the establishment of All India Muslim League in 1906, the Muslims of India came to have their own political party which can speak and protect their rights. Later on, this party turned into large and played an important role for the Indian Muslims in their freedom movement. It was a driving force behind the creation of Pakistan as a Muslim state on the Indian subcontinent. So, it played a very important role and finally it resulted into the partitioning of the subcontinent and the formation of Muslim League. During the period of 1906 to 1909, British India saw political agitation to pressurize the government in acceding to into their demands. The partition of Bengal in 1905 under Lord Curzon created discontent amongst the Hindu population of Bengal. Then we discussed that a Muslim delegation met Lord Minto at Shimla in 1905 to put forward the demands of the Muslim community for representation in the government in the form of separate electorates. So these were also discussed with the Secretary of State for India, John Morley, who agreed to some of the demands. So Congress had already been formed in 1885 and was gaining political will, and the Muslim League was formed in 1906 to voice the demands of the Muslim community. So at this time, the British thought that they should introduce the reforms which were the Morley Minto reforms introduced by them in 1909. 3 years after the formation of the All India Muslim League, Morley Minto reforms were introduced in 1909, which contained the most important demand of All India Muslim League, which was the separate electorate. In 1905, Lord Minto as Viceroy replaced Lord Curzon, and in 1906, John Morley was appointed as Secretary of State of India. Both Lord Minto and Secretary of State John Morley were convinced that the Indians' demand for an increased share in the government of their country was fully justified. So they worked together to draw up a series of reforms which were passed by the British Parliament in 1909 and known as the Indian Council Act, as popularly known as Morley Minto reforms. These are the main provisions of the reforms. Muslim representatives to the councils were elected by a separate Muslim only electorate. The Imperial Council was increased to 60 members by adding more non-official members. However, the British retained control by ensuring that the majority of members were official. Members of Central Executive Council were permitted to discuss budget, administration, official policies and matters of general importance. Provincial councils were also increased to 50 members in the large provinces and 30 in the smaller provinces. So these are the main provisions of the Morley Minto reforms. Now, let's have a look on the consequences of these reforms or the effects of these reforms on Indians. The most important consequence of the reform was the acceptance of separate electorates for the Muslims. The Hindu argued that this was undemocratic, and for the next 25 years, Congress was to pass an annual resolution calling for an end to separate electorates. The Morley Minto reforms increased the number of Indians sitting on the councils, but the important thing here is that their functions were purely advisory. The British did not intend that the locals should have the power to change government policy. The British acceptance of the rights of the Muslim to have separate electorates was its main feature and the first step towards Pakistan. So although they increased the number of Indians, they gave them more representations, but their status was just to give an advice. They retained the main power. The British retained the main power. They didn't give any real power to the Indians. So let's recap whatever we have read today. We earlier discussed about the formation of the Indian National Congress. In 1885, when Indian National Congress was formed, Sir Said advised the Muslim not to join Indian National Congress, as this party was only working for the benefits of Hindus. So, due to the unhealthy condition, the Muslim subcontinent forced to form their own political party apart from Indian National Congress for the protection of their rights, because we have discussed that Indian National Congress was only working for the Hindus. It has nothing to do with the rights and the aspirations of the Muslim. It completely ignored the aspiration, the feelings of the Muslim. And the Muslims have seen their reaction toward the partitioning of Bengal. So they formed their own political body, which not only could counter the growing influence of All India, Indian National Congress, but could also protect their rights and advance their aspirations. It could represent Muslim needs and aspiration to the government of India. It could also promote feelings of loyalty to the British government and to remove any misunderstandings among the Muslims as to the intentions of any government. And moreover, in order to prevent the rise of hostility in Muslim towards other communities in India. So it was very important for the survival of the Muslims at that time. The All India Muslim League was a political party which was established in 1906 in British India. It proved to be a driving force behind the creation of Pakistan as a Muslim state on the Indian subcontinent. 3 years after the formation of the All India Muslim League, the Morley Minto reforms were introduced, which contained the most important demand of the Muslim League, which was granting the separate electorate to the Muslims, although the Hindus were not happy with it. The reforms were not very much successful. They didn't fulfill the demands of the Indians. But the good thing was this, that it fulfilled the demand of the Muslim, which was to grant them the separate electorate. So the most important consequence of the reform was the acceptance of the separate electorate for Muslims. I hope you learned a lot from today's lesson. We have covered the timeline from 1885 to 1911. A few of the topics we covered in the previous lesson, and in today's lesson we completed the whole of this timeline. This is your written task. There are three questions. First one is, why did Sir Sayyid ask the Muslims to keep away from the Congress? Why did a Muslim delegation meet the Viceroy Lord Minto at Shimla in 1905? And explain the Minto-Mawley reforms of 1909. Write down the answers of all these questions, keeping in view the marking scheme, taking the help from your both the books, Understanding History by Ismat Riaz and The History and Culture of Pakistan by Nigel Kelly. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson, and you must have learned a lot from today's lesson. So, best of luck.